I love the way it feels, the way it smells, the way the light falls on it, the texture, and also to connect between the past and the future.
My name is Ronald Rael. I am a professor of architecture and also the chair of the Department of Art Practice. I've been challenged to give a 101 on earthen architecture in 101 seconds. What do I mean by earthen architecture? Buildings made of earth, dirt, the soil underneath our feet. Some of the oldest buildings on the planet are made of earth. We can find the homes of presidents, embassies and airports and cultural institutions made simply out of soil to create buildings that are up to 10 stories tall. There are many forms of earthen construction. An adobe is a brick that is made out of mud that dries in the sun. There are compressed earth blocks. There's something called rammed earth, earth that's compacted in forms. There's wattle and daub, mud that's applied to a weaving of branches. I'm personally interested in buildings made of earth because I grew up in Colorado in a multi-generational house built by my great-grandfather made out of mud. When I was in architecture school, I became very fascinated to learn that architects like Frank Lloyd Wright or Rudolf Schindler were also designing buildings made of earth, even though they're most famous for concrete and glass and steel. They hadn't abandoned earthen architectural heritage. If you're a prospective student and you want to come to Berkeley and learn more about earthen architecture, it's a really important time where the climate is changing. Concrete is one of the largest contributors to carbon dioxide emissions on the planet. But earthen construction produces no carbon dioxide emissions. Earth buildings are fire resistant. They're also non-toxic. One of the futures of earthen construction is using additive manufacturing or 3D printing. Rather than using our hands to apply mud, we can use robots to apply mud. And that's one of the things I work on here at the university. I call this process mud and machines. Sometimes I call it AI. I think it's interesting to think about not only artificial intelligence, but ancestral intelligence to draw from our 10,000-year-old heritage of building with earth.